You know, you could see the whole board.
Now I see that you're just as backwards as all the other people in this damn town. You niggas from New York, you always act like your shit don't stink. I ain't gonna go that far, but we definitely slicker than you motherfuckers, for sure.
My daddy had a saying, Detroit ain't about open hands, we about closed fists. Anybody who think otherwise will get knocked the fuck out.
BMF, episode 5, gave us one of the most iconic scenes we've seen in TV. By far one of the top two best scenes of this entire series, when we got Steve and Wood Harris opposite of each other for the first time in TV, these acting brothers in real life. A lot of y'all didn't even know these two was brothers. You do remember them from some of the iconic roles they've played in the past, like this one involving Wood in The Wire.
Since when do we buy corners? We take corners.
Man, you gonna buy one way or another. How much money can a nigga make?
More than a nigga can spend.
And then we ain't gonna be around to spend what we done made already.
Shit, I didn't think I was gonna be around this long.
Or when a lot of you black women started hating light-skinned women with wavy hair from Steve's role in this.
No easy way to say this. It's over.
Oh.
No?
No!
No! You put me out of the house.
Who house?
Our house.
Exactly. Come
on. Diary of a Mad Black Woman. Yes, he acted that thing so well, it seemed so natural, y'all was hating his ass. But this was the first time the brothers actually got to put themselves on display, and they actually did an interview, and we're going to discuss that right now. If you're finding me for the first time, please subscribe to the channel. Be sure to turn on notifications so when I drop videos, you get them. Follow me on Instagram, man. The way I communicate with my subscribers from YouTube is through DMs on Instagram. I typically respond to everybody that sends me a message, so hit me on IG. Steve Harris recently did an interview in which he talked about the way it felt to work with his brother on BMF. Now, mind you, ladies and gentlemen, this is not the first time they've been on set together. They did work together in a show called Justified from 2010, but they didn't have scenes where they were opposite of each other, dueling with each other. So Steve dropped some notes on it. He was basically talking about how 50 Cent had so much respect for the two, and that in this scene where they're opposite of each other, they were allowed a little bit of leeway to really go at it with each other. And so they set the tone to make this thing iconic. Did you guys pay attention to the jazz music they was playing in the background? If you didn't, here's another clip.
That's cute. Yeah, it is. But for you, it's a premonition. See, you a dinosaur, Pat. And I'm the nigga gonna make you extinct. Trust me when I say it, our next meeting won't be this peaceful.
Yeah. Like Steve said, they wrote it, talking about the production team for BMF. But the brothers, we made it ours, Steve Harris add. Working with Wood is a pleasure. There have been so many years when we didn't work together. Hell, some people still don't know we're brothers, even to this day. Given that this show is about brothers and family, it made sense. Family has always been first for us. So to get the opportunity to play off each other, gives me an added layer of appreciation. It was really cool that they gave us that to do, and I'm hoping they'll give us more to do in season 2. Well, ladies and gentlemen, he done just told you that basically neither one of them is gonna die in season 1. So you can just go ahead and put those theories to bed. I just saved some of my theory crafters out there in YouTube a whole lot of time. Ain't neither one of them dying in this season. Steve just spilled all the tea. But I find it wonderful that in this series, they got a chance to go at it with each other. This has been one of my top scenes I've seen so far from this episode. And it's good. It's kind of good to see this, but it's hard to believe that these dudes have not come across each other as long as they've been acting. I mean, when you think about it, Steve has been acting ever since 1984. He goes back that far up until this day, And his brother Wood has been acting ever since 1994, where he started out in Above the Rim. Do you guys remember that? And then he went on to do series like NYPD Blue, Oz. He did Cosby, the TV series. He was even in New York Undercover back in 1998. So there's a long lineage between these two. And it was just really, really good to see these OGs in the acting game come together to put together one of the top scenes I've seen on TV in a very long time. But leave me all your comments. How do you guys feel about this scene? Was this in your top three for the season? And are you interested to see where they take their story next season? Because they basically just done spilled all the tea and told us that he's going to be around. Both of them are going to be around for the next season. And I hope that the writers give us more scenes with these brothers, because they lit the screen up. I enjoyed it. And it's good to see these OGs getting to work together and really go at it with each other. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like the video. Please comment, subscribe. Go get yourself that life game. Be sure to follow me on Instagram. Whenever you want to talk to me or communicate with me, it's easier for me to catch you guys' comments on IG if you have something you want to say to me personally. So hit me on IG. And until that next Sex Is Hell video, I'll see you.